Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Standard 4th, EVS 1, Chapter number 24, Are We Endangering Our Environment? Here, two pictures they are given, 20 years ago and today. You can see the difference in these two places. In first picture, we were attached towards our environment, and in another picture we are cleared all the forest areas and we are having our houses there. Means the settlement development had been taken place here. Twenty years ago, there were open fields around the city. Today, there are new colonies there. There was a big spreading tree near the railway gate. Different kinds of birds and insects lived happily in the tree. Where have those birds and insects gone today? As we can see, due to scarcity of trees, birds do not find any shelter to build their nest. They also find the smoke in the city. They feel troublesome there. They are no longer sure of getting water. Then they are thirsty. So, we see less birds in the cities. And they had been gone towards the other areas where trees and water facilities are there. What similarities do you find between a city, a village and a forest? Let's see. City picture they had given, village picture they had given and the forest picture they had given. So if you will see in these two pictures, there are no similarities in cities, village and forest. But there is a similarity in city and village. That is, people live in city and village. The people in forest, they are not living in that picture. What differences do you find between them? Here we can see in these two pictures, in between city and village. If you will see, in a city the population is more and in a village the population is less. In city they has highways and other roads. Here in villages they are having we can see not as much built roads. Again, we can see big tail buildings are there, and in villages we see one or two storied houses. The progress made by human beings. Man is more intelligent than all other animals. He makes use of his intelligence to make his life more comfortable. As we know, we human beings, we are intelligent than the animals. So we make use of our intelligence and we make the work more easier and as according to our comfort. All living things make use of what they find in their environment, but only man can carefully study the things in the environment. So as if we will talk about the animals, whatever they find near them, they accept that thing. But we human beings, we make changes on them according to observation and according to our need. He produces new things from materials in the environment. Let us see how. This is a story of about 150 years ago. Researchers found out how to use mineral oil. Man now had a new and useful fuel to use. He then invented some vehicles that would run on this fuel. This includes the motor car, bus, truck and scooter. They also developed railway engines that would run on coal. Previously, if one had to travel to another town, one had to walk or ride horseback or on a bullock cart. Various animals were used to carry burdens or to draw the carts. Now, we go by bus or railway trains that helps to save both time and labor. As this is the difference between the two lives, as before the inventions and after the inventions. And after the invention, when the researchers, they had found mineral oil, the man, we human beings, we had started making research on it, that how we can make use of this mineral oil in our day-to-day life. So according to it, they had started preparing different vehicles and they had put on the fuel on it, and due to which they can run easily, and whenever we want, we can make use of that vehicles as according to our need, and within a limited time we can move from one place to another places. Comparing to the previous time, at that time the people, they were traveling through horse ride or by walk or by other ways. We take up various schemes to make our life easier and prosperous. We build dams to satisfy our need for water. We build roads and railways for transportation. Factories are set up to manufacture all the things we need. We build houses so that everyone can have a shelter of their own. As according to our need, we are moving towards our development and we are making our work more easier. As we find that there is a need for factories to manufacture different products, we have started making factories and we have started manufacturing different products in that factories. And transportation of roads and railways had been built. Again, different dams they had built, so that through that dams we can collect the water in dam and we can make use of that water whole year. The things we need to do, all this have to be obtained from the environment. We get them from places like forest, farms and mines. Water is used in the factories and then the wastewater is let into rivers. All this has an effect on the environment. If the environment is harmed, it has harmful effects on all living things, and man is no exception. So as we get all the things from the environment, but we have to think that how much we have to make use of that things which we get from environment. If once they are finished, we will not be able to refill it, or we cannot enjoy it again in the future one. So whatever the things we are getting from the environment, we have to make use of that materials in a proper way. Growth of the population. A census was done in 1951. What was the population of our country then? So according to this question, the census which was taken in 1951, at that time 36.1 crore was our population. A census was done in 2011. What was the population of our country then? So as according to this question, the census which was taken in 2011, that time our population was 121.02 crores. So this was the difference between these 2 years. In 1951, the population was not that much as compared to 2011. And in 2011, the population has rise lot. In the last 60 years, the population of our country has tripled. It is still growing. So the demand for all those things that we need to take from the environment has increased many times over. So as comparing to this 2 years, in 1951 and according to the population of 2011, we can see as the population is increasing, the man's needs also starts increasing. So to complete the need of human beings, what we do, we make excessive use of our environment products. People could not get employment in village, so they begin to live and to go to the cities in search of work. Cities became crowded, the population in the cities grew beyond limits, cities began to experience a shortage of water. There were not enough houses for everybody, so people could not find a place to stay. There used to be open space and fields around the cities. New colonies came up there, and to build these new houses and colonies, the trees there had to be cut down. So as according to the need, as the population increases in cities, the settlement should be also increased. So to complete their shelter need, the humans, they have to cut down the forest, and in that place they have to settle their life. In cities, one has to travel long distance to get to work. So people in cities begin to buy vehicles that run on fumes. In all big cities, these vehicles spew smoke as they are driven around. The smoke mixes with the city air. As a result, people begin to have breathing problems. Instances of asthma and other lung disorders begin to increase. So as according to this, as in cities the population increases, the need of shelter also increases, due to which the people, they start cutting the trees, and due to which the eco-friendly nature or a good environment cannot be fine for the people. As according to their need, as the factories or other industries to go for a job, they need vehicle. So for this purpose, they make excessive use of vehicles, and from that vehicles, the smoke which emits from the vehicles, it gets harmful for the human beings. So as different diseases or different problems had been created in the cities, as like breathing problem, or it also can lead to a asthma problem, or other disorders can be seen in the different peoples, resulting towards the lung disorders, or other disorders can be also seen. Trees have been banished from cities, so birds do not find places to build their nest. They also find the smoke in the city air troublesome. They are no longer sure of getting water when they are thirsty. So there are fewer and fewer birds in cities now. The number of butterflies and other insects is also falling. So as comparing to this, as the population level is more in cities, there is no trees as much compared to the villages, due to which the birds, they cannot find a tree to have their nest. And also from the vehicles, they get disturbed, due to which they move to other places like villages. Because of the increasing population, the drainage system in cities fails sometimes. Then water collects in the middest of the living areas. Mosquitoes grow in it. They spread diseases like malaria, dengue, filaria, chikungunya. Do you see how the increase in the population spoils the life we lead in cities? So as we can see here, as the increasing population, the drainage, they get choked, and due to which the mosquitoes and they breed there, and due to which different diseases take place like malaria, dengue, filaria and chikungunya. This all are the diseases which might be taking place due to mosquitoes. Do you see how the increase in the population spoils the life we lead in cities? Yes, as the garbage disposal, it gets difficulty to collect the garbage. Also, the facilities which might be related to house, as people easily, they cannot find any house to stay. These are the problems which can lead in a city due to increase in population. Groundwater is drying up. Water is an important need of all living things. We use water for keeping ourselves and our houses clean, for cooking, farming, industry and construction. As we know, water is our need. Without water, we cannot think of our living things, or we living beings, we cannot live without water. So as like for keeping ourselves, or for cleaning our house, or for other work, we need water. As the rainy season ends, the water in rivers decreases. Water in wells, too, it resides. Their water barrel lasts up to the month of the March. The following year, later in summer, many villages face a serious scarcity of water. Yes, many times the situation we had seen in cities and also in villages also. As the rainy season ends, the wells, they start drying, and up to the March, or when the summer season starts, at that time we face serious problem about the scarcity of water in cities and villages in both the places. Do you know, people settle only where water is available from one source or the other. Yes, wherever the water will be there, human settlements will be seen in that places only, because water is our basic need. Dam, hand pump, you can see, these are the other ways as during the scarcity of water we can make use of this two options. The population keeps growing, the rainfall however remains the same, so there is a shortage of water. Much of rainwater flows away unused, so we begin to build dams to store rainwater and use it later. So as by using the intellect of human beings, we started building dam, and according to the rainy season, the water gets stored in the dam, and when the need of water arises, at that time that water is used for the survival of human beings. Some people begin to use bore wells rather than draw wells, and to use hand pumps to lift water. Then pumps that worked mechanically or diesel or electricity were invented. Now the use of such pumps has become widespread. So as previously we had seen the bore wells and draw wells and hand pumps, but nowadays the people, they are using other mechanical ways which works on electricity or on diesel. So these are the new inventions which was done by the human beings. The population has so greatly increased that now every summer we face severe water scarcity. So as according to our population, as the population is increasing day by day, we feel scarcity of water in cities and in villages. Another problem that the population growth caused was that of availability of food. The food produced in the country began to fall short of the need of the growing population. So our scientists developed improved methods of farming. Previously, farmers would grow only one crop in the year. Now, they can take two or even three crops every year. As a result, food production increased, but so did the demand for water for agriculture. Here, you can see, as the population growth increases, different problems like scarcity of food, water also arises. To complete this task, which is related to food, as previously in our country, in a year, a farmer was carrying only one crop, but due to new inventions and due to the help of or from the help of scientists, different inventions had been taken place, and due to which within a year, two to three crops we can grow and which can fulfill the demand of the population. Use your brain power. Previously, water was needed for farming only during the rainy season. Now, it is needed for 8 months in the year. Where three crops are taken, it is required all year round. It only rains during the rainy season. Then, from where do we get the water for farming and for all other needs? As according to this question, we can see farmers, they grow two or three crops a year instead of one crop. So through pumps are used to lift water even after the rainy season. So water stored underground gets used up rapidly. Or bore wells can be used so that we can make use of the underground water when the water is needed after rainy season. We experience scarcity of water soon after the rains. From where do we get water for the fields in summer and in the winter? So as from the rivers, from artificial dams, we can get the water in summer and in winter season. Rainwater that has spilled into the soil can be used in this situation. Water found in wells and bore wells is nothing but rainwater that has spilled into the ground. So as if we will not store the rainwater, so what will happen? It get absorbed in the ground, and the groundwater level will be increased, and through that groundwater, when the summer season or winter season will be there, at that time by using different pumps or hand pumps we can make available that water. Let us learn about some traditional methods of drawing water from wells. In the Konkan region, there are groves of coconut, betel nut and bananas. They are watered using the water wheel to lift water from the well. A horizontal beam is placed over the mouth on the wheel. It supports a large wooden wheel which turns around. This wheel is called the rahat. Several pots gedge are fixed on the wheel. When the wheel turns, the chain of pots turns with it. One by one, they dip into the water in the well and get filled as they come up. As the wheel turns, each pot turns over and the water gets poured into a canal. From there, it is taken to the groves. The water wheel is turned with the help of bullock or a male buffalo. Such water wheels or rahat gat are still in use in some places in the Konkan region. So here, the two places they had given, as with the help of these animals, we can make the rahat gat. You can see the moat. You can see a bucket or a container is tied near the well, and with the help of animals, by making the animals by moving forward and backward, we can collect the water from the well. In other parts of Maharashtra, a moat was in use for lifting water, well water. A moat is a large leather bag. It is lowered into the water at the end of a rope. When it is full, it is lifted out of the well. The water is used for the fields. Bullocks move to and fro on a ramp to help lower the bag and lift it. The moat is used in very few places now. You can about the rahat gat and moat, you can get more information and videos through YouTube channels. You can collect the information from this about these two situations or conditions, you can see. Through internet you have to find out more information about this two events which has taken place in this, which is given on page number 150. How the water is carried in the previous time, as we were not having any electric or mechanical mechanism. Let's see the next part. Nowadays, fields are watered using diesel or electric pumps. These mechanical pumps can lift many times more water than the moats ever could. So as these two pictures, it relates to our pastime. As about in villages or in some of the parts of Konkan, as they had given, in that region we can see these two methods which are used to draw water from the well. But nowadays we make use of the diesel pumps and other electric pumps. Through that we can easily take out the water from the, or we can lift the water from the well. Besides, because more than one crop is taken every year, the pumps are used to lift water even after the rainy season. As a result, the water stored underground is getting used up rapidly. So as due to the electric pump, we are making use of that pump whenever we need. As anytime we can put on the button and we can collect the water from the ground. So as the situation changes, as the development is taking place, we are becoming overburdened on the ground or on the environment. Let's check what we had learned in this chapter. Vehicles like motor cars, buses and scooters that run on mineral oil were invented. So two very railway trains, it made traveling easier. So as comparing to the previous time, as the railway, within a shorter time we can move from one place to another places. So the inventions which had been taken place are the motor cars, buses, scooters, which run on mineral oil, it becoming easier to us to find out a way to travel from one place to another place in a limited duration. We built dams, roads and railways, we set up factories and built houses, we release wastewater from factories into rivers. This causes harm to the environment as well as to the living things in it. Yes, whatever the garbage we throw or the waste material which is thrown by the factories and industries, it causes harm to the good water, which can be made use for our daily use or for the agriculture production. As the population keeps growing, the demand for things we get from the environment also grows in leaps and bounds. Cities become crowded as people left their village in search for work. Trees were cut down to build new houses, the number of vehicles increased, the smoke began to cause breathing disorders. Yes, as the village peoples, they move towards the cities in search of jobs. So due to which here in cities the population increases, and to complete the need of the settlement, the forest areas or the trees are cut down and there the settlements are settled. Due to which the vehicles also increase due to increase in population, and which creates smoke in that area and which creates breathing disorders in cities. As trees are felled, birds do not find nesting places. There is smoke too. As a result, the number of birds, butterflies and other insects in cities are falling. Yes, we can see rarely nowadays, we can see the butterflies in area, as due to population and due to pollution and due to different reasons, the birds and other insects, they are moving towards the villages, because there the population is less and the pollution is also less. The greater the population, the greater is the demand for food grain. Farmers now take multiple crops, the demand of water too increases. Yes, as according to the growing population, the demand for food will be also increase. So to complete the demand of food grain, the farmers now take multiple crops. But before this, the farmers, they were carrying only one crop in a year. But now a time, due to different inventions, the farmers, they are making multi crops within a year. One or two or three crops they are carrying. And also the demand for water is increasing, as according to increase in demand of food grains. Previously in Konkan, the water wheel was used to draw well water, while the moat was used elsewhere in Maharashtra. Now pumps are used for the purpose in most places. So groundwater gets used up rapidly. So as in, we can see the two pictures which I had shown you. There were the two options in previous time to draw water from the water wheel and by the way of moat to collect the water from the ground and or from the well. But nowadays, by using the pumps, we can make the water easily available. So as the groundwater can be made easily available through the pumps or by the diesel pumps or electric pumps. So these were all the points which we had discussed in this chapter. So in this way, we had completed this chapter. Are we endangering our environment? Complete the given exercise, read the chapter once again, and learn the given question and answers. That's all for today. Thank you.